Hi everyone. In this lecture, we'll design the sign-up scene. It's pretty similar to the sign-in scene, so we can actually duplicate the sign-in scene and start from there. However, let's revisit the design guideline stuff from last time. Recall that to see how a particular UI element is positioned relatively to others, we can select that object, the email text field, for example, and hold the Option key. We can now see its distance to the edges of the scene. To know how far it is from the password text field, still hold Control and hover the password text field. We can do the same thing for the other elements as well. For now, the numbers are kind of random, so let's stick to some good ones. Let's distance the elements evenly for consistency. Instead of dragging these UI objects around, another way is to set their absolute location in the size inspector. So to position the password text field 20 points below the email text field, instead of 17 as of now, we can add 3 more points to its current vertical position in the size inspector. We can then do the same thing to the sign in button to position it 20 points below the password text field. Okay, good. Instead of 20 points, you can reuse the margin of these elements, which is 16 points. It really depends on you. As long as it's not too close or too far. All right, great. Now, let's build the signup view. As we mentioned before, the signup scene is quite similar to the sign-in scene. We can actually duplicate the sign-in scene and start from there. All right, now, there are 2 ways of duplicating this sign-in scene. The first one, well, not surprisingly at all, is to select the sign-in scene, hit Command-C to copy, and then Command-V to paste it. However, Xcode offers another way to duplicate UI objects, which kind of fits this purpose. That is, you can select the sign-in scene, then hit Command-D, where D is probably short for duplicate. Then drag the newly duplicated scene to somewhere else, because now it's on top of the original one. Now, the first thing you should do is to set up its identity properly in its identity inspector. Instead, we'll create another subclass of the UIViewController class to back this signup scene, because the two scenes should behave differently. Now, as before, go back to the storyboard to link the storyboard signup view to the new custom UIViewController class. We'll code up the signup functionality in this class later, but it's a good idea to set things up first. Now, let's go back to the UI. Actually, let's review our design to see what we need to do. Okay, we need one more text field for username and a UI image view for profile photo, which is this one. Note that we use email only for user login, which is pretty common. Finally, we simply change the display text for the button at the bottom. All right, let's do it. Actually, we need to change this button title from sign in to something related to sign up too. Now, to create the username text field, as it's very similar to the other ones, we can start by duplicating the email text field. Then, locate it above the email text field to match the design. All right. Now, make sure to position it consistently. Here, we'll distance it, also 20 points, from the one below it, by adjusting its vertical position in its size inspector. All right. Great. Everything looks good now. One more thing, let's modify the placeholder in its attribute inspector to match its function. Something related to username. Alright, looks good. Okay, let's finish easy tasks first. We want the bottom button to allow users to switch back to the login view. So let's set its title to something indicating that function, like switch back to login or already have an account. It's your choice, as long as you can tell what this button does. But don't make it too long, like 2 lines of text. People are lazy, and so are your users. All right, now, let's build something to let users upload their profile pictures. We'll get an UI image view by searching for it in the object library. Then, drag it to the scene. If you want, you can adjust its size in its size inspector. Here, we set its width and height to the 50 points, but there's no right or wrong number here. It really depends on you, as long as the whole scene doesn't look unbalanced. All right, looks good. Let's build the app and see. But before that, we need to make sure when the app launches, this signup scene will show up first by checking its isInitialViewController in its attribute inspector. Before that, the login scene, which is the default one when we created the project, is the initial scene. So it will show up first unless we make that change, and currently the app can't switch views. All right. The app runs smoothly, but do things look good? Okay, something is missing. We put down the UI of image view, but we don't see it here. Well, actually, it is there, only we can't see it, because it's empty now. It's not good this way, because users won't see it too. Alright, so, let's do something to indicate that users can use it to upload profile photos. A common way is to leave some sort of default or placeholder photo. So let's go back to the storyboard to make the UI of ImageViewController display a default photo. Xcode offers a convenient way for doing things like this. We'll import the default photo that we want to place in Xcode, kind of like an asset, then link it to the UI ImageViewController. Here we use this photo, but you can use your own if you have one. Now, choose the assets.xc assets file in Xcode, then drag the photo into this place. All right, good. We can now head back to the storyboard to link it to the UI image view controller. We do that by setting the image property in the attribute inspector of the UI image view controller. All right, to this photo. Great. The default photo shows up nicely already. Let's build the app and check it out. In the meantime, know that the app is not in a good shape now. It's kind of useless to display one scene only. The app should let users switch view smoothly. All right. Looks pretty good. That's quite enough for the UI. Next, we'll stick to an initial view, then let users switch between the two views nicely. Precisely, we let users switch from the login scene to the sign up scene by touching this button. And do the same thing for the sign up scene. It depends on your app or business model to decide which scene should show up first. Alright, here we let that be the login scene. Now, select the switching button. To enable its view switching function, hold Control and drag it to the view controller that we want to switch to. Then check the present modally option in the pop-up menu. All right, now we can switch views. Let's see how it works. By the way, what we've just did was creating a segue object, which is represented by the arrow between two views. Present modally means the sign-in view controller presents the sign-up view controller. Okay, good. Here the segue starting point is the switching button, so it'll initiate the transition when touched. Now, we'll let this button allow users to switch back to the login view, meaning we need to dismiss this modal transition and return to the original view controller. Selecting the signup view controller, then Control, click the storyboard file to open the storyboard in the assistant editor. The easiest way to dismiss this modal transition is doing it in code. So the idea is, if users touch this already having an account, button, so this button needs to do something to respond to users' taps. We need an IB action to code up its behaviors. To do so, hold Control, then drag from this button to the signupViewController Swift file, then release. Okay. Now, set the connection type to action. We need a meaningful name for this action. To truly describe what we're going to code up for this button, we'll name this dismiss on click. All right. Then hit connect after we're done. As we use the sign in view controller to present this sign up view controller, it's a good idea to simply dismiss this sign up view controller using the dismiss method. The animated parameter can be set to true, and the completion block can just be set to nil so that we don't want to do anything else after dismissing. All right. Let's run the app and see. Okay, let's see. Switch view, then switch back. Very smooth, right? Okay, let's close down the assistant editor and focus on the storyboard only. All right. We will add the Instagram text to the sign-in view. It's some sort of text, so we can use a UI text label for it. So let's search for a UI text label in the object library, then drag it to the storyboard. In its attribute inspector, type in its text content. Then set the text color to a bright one to make it contrast with the dark background. Okay. The text is cut off, so select the label and hit Command with the equal sign. The label will adjust itself to fully display its text content. All right. Good. Now we need this text to look interesting and to be larger. So, choose Font, then select Custom to select non-system fonts. In the font family, select anything you like to make it look interesting. If the list doesn't have the font you like, you can download and put it in this list. All right. We actually like something simple, but if you want something fancy, you can choose the noteworthy font. All right. All right, good. Now enlarge it by setting its size to a large number. Use the Command equal trick again to fully display the text. All right, great. Looks pretty decent, right? All right, let's see. All right, great. We'll learn Stack View next time. All right, see you then.